So today we are talking about cloud gaming. We're going to learn how it works, different platforms, what games are on it, who's using it, how they're using it, how it's useful now, and how it will be useful in the future. And we're doing that to see basically how our game development journeys will fit into it. Maybe we'll learn about it and think, you know, not for me, I don't need to put my games on these platforms, I don't need to think about it. More likely, there might be games that we're going to be making in the future that will fit well into cloud gaming. If these platforms become very common and very standard, it'd be great to know ahead of time how to put our games onto it, how to, you know, go about that. Because at the moment, I have no idea how to do it. Personally, I don't know how I would do it. And I think that the first step is knowing when we want to do it and how to do it so that when the time comes, we're able to, and we're at least knowing what direction to go in. So we're going to start off our segment watching some videos about cloud gaming, just kind of getting a better grasp on what cloud gaming is and how it works so that we can understand the next step, which is the development part. And this is a partnership with Microsoft Azure. This is why we're talking about it, is because they have a new program. I think that they started accepting beta testers to the program in January, and I think you can still sign up for beta. You can apply to the beta program, and if you get in, there's a lot of benefits, like you get credits towards Microsoft Azure, you get, I think, a free year of PlayFab, of the paid part of PlayFab, which is, you know, the next tier up. They're also there to help walk you through things where you get stuck, answer questions. And if you are going into cloud game development, they are there to take feedback from you if you're not happy with things, and they're going to be using that feedback to make their programs and platforms better. So I think that's kind of cool that we can expect even better services and platforms for cloud game development in the future. With that, let's get started. Here's the Azure, ID at Azure landing page that you can get from that link. Some of the things that they point out is you can develop faster. So there's $5,000 in Azure credits. That's quite a bit. Free Azure PlayFab standard plan for 2 years. That's more than I thought even. Free multiplayer services, including PlayFab party networking, voice chat, PlayFab matchmaking, and PlayFab lobby, up to included limits. So you basically have a wider range of testing space for these platforms, which, I mean, I'm already curious of these things. Having free access for a couple of years is like makes that even more enticing. I don't know if you guys have tried multiplayer before or any of these things that they mentioned, networking, voice and chat, matchmaking, lobby. That stuff looks really complicated to put together independently, and you still have to pay for a hosting service for that, or servers for that. So, and the thing about that is, like, if you're paying for your own servers, it's expensive to set up even if nobody plays it. It's really cool to have tools like this that you can try it out for free, see how it goes, and then, you know, you can always migrate away from it if you don't like it, but it's going to be more cost effective to experiment with this than it would be to do your own thing, which is also going to be likely more work. Really cool that they're offering that there. Work smarter, not harder. Curated solutions, architectures, and use cases. Curated educational resources for all levels of cloud experience. So if you don't know much about it, they're there to help answer questions. If you do, if you're familiar with cloud game development, they're there to give you more complex answers to more complex things that you're doing. They have training modules, code samples from GitHub, case studies from game developers, example solutions, architectures, and use cases. Very cool. I actually signed up to this program and I've only just started to get into it, but I'm looking forward to learning more about this. Support along the journey. So here's what I was talking about, that they have people that you can speak to. Top tier support from Azure Rapid Response, ticketed PlayFab support, exclusive office hours, and expert sessions. So they do give you a lot of support. I think it's definitely worth checking out if this is something that's up your alley. So this is a free program, by the way. You don't pay anything for this. This is free. They give you free access to things. Some of PlayFab, like multiplayer services, is paid, but if you have 2 years free, it's definitely cool to experiment with it at least for 2 years. And if you get something that's working well, you can figure out the pricing at that point or migrate away if you don't like their pricing. It's a great way to experiment for sure. So ID at Xbox is a similar platform for if you want to get your games on Xbox. So I don't know if anyone's done that before. This is a program to help you with that. You do have to apply for it. If they like your game, they will bring you into the program and help you get your game on Xbox. In a similar way, ID at Azure, if you apply to it and if you have a rough game idea, like, I think that they're pretty open at this point, so don't feel like you need to have like amazing game, but if you have something, you have an idea and you want to start looking into it further, you can apply and they will, you know, if they think this is something that you might benefit from, then they'll bring you on board and help you with anything cloud gaming related. So they kind of work well together, or, you know, if you're doing Xbox or if you're doing this, then you kind of have a similar idea of what they are. So that's a little bit about ID at Azure. We'll watch some videos on this in a bit, but let's learn about cloud gaming first.
You have games that you own and you want to play them elsewhere. You may not have a gaming computer, but you need to have a computer.
Okay.
You just pay NVIDIA for the privilege of being able to play anywhere. Or you don't pay. There's a free tier. And if you do pay, it's only $5 a month.
So there are several services other than NVIDIA's GeForce Now and Google's Stadia.
The biggest changes are pretty much going to be upgrades to the services and I guess getting some more games partners on board. But the ones that are probably going to make the biggest splash are going to be your Sony and your Amazons because they have some big things in the pipeline.
This is interesting. We have learned a lot today from our cloud gaming research session. We know that there's a number of platforms that offer cloud gaming services. There's major tech companies who have these platforms, more and more coming, popping up. We even are seeing them come from non-gaming companies like Netflix, which is very interesting. We know that they operate in different ways. Some of them do require you to buy the game or have subscriptions to the game, but there's also the option to use a Steam library to have access to your library of games, then pay a subscription to play those games on devices that you otherwise wouldn't be able to, like a phone or a tablet. So that's pretty cool. I'm personally excited about cloud gaming because I am all about reaching new people who may not have taken an interest in gaming. Because imagine if there were people who didn't watch movies because they thought that movies weren't made for them, or like they just, you'd be missing out on something that could be so interesting and thought-provoking and make you happy and make you see things in new ways or inspire you. I love the idea of more people taking an interest in gaming. So to overcome the initial cost of getting into gaming, that is buying a console or a gaming computer, that's a great thing. Cloud gaming is able to offer that to people. We also know, depending on the platform, different devices are offered. So you may be able to play on a phone, you may be able to play on a TV, you may be able to play on a console or a computer, you may even be able to play on a very old, out-of-date computer, but play more complex games on it through cloud gaming. But there's a lot of different options, and it depends which platform for cloud gaming that you're using. Some major titles across the different platforms, different games on different platforms, and it's something that seems to be growing and growing, and I'm excited to see where it goes. As for ID at Azure, they offer a program to help onboard you and give you resources for developing for cloud gaming. They also have tools like Azure and PlayFab, which they do give credits for, but they will give you access to all types of learning so that you can figure out how and what it takes to make games for cloud gaming. So personally, that's important to me because I can figure out the work that would go into building for cloud gaming so I can evaluate whether or not it's worth doing for a game. So for example, I'm currently going to be releasing my game or desktop on through Steam. If it's not too difficult, I'd love to be able to reach new people through cloud gaming. Knowing what goes into that would be the first step in even considering it, basically. It might be a lot of work, in which case I can be like, okay, this is gonna be a lot of work, but there's a lot of interest, a lot of people like the game. Let's put some resources towards building it out for cloud gaming. Or maybe I'll find out that it's really not that hard and I could reach so many more people without that much effort. So I'm personally excited to learn more about cloud gaming and developing for it. And I'm definitely gonna be factoring that into my decision-making on how I'm releasing my games. Thank you guys for joining in on our cloud gaming segment.